Alrighty, hey guys, it's Aeon back with this Oddity Xi25. And today I'll be speedrunning setting up Betaflight on this Tmotor F7 all-in-one. And yes, I said speedrunning, because this is just a short version of a longer video I'm planning to release about Betaflight 4.4 and above, and all of its setup and features. So let's jump right in. I'm going to plug a USB into the Tmotor F7 and open Betaflight. But, oh no! It's not recognized. What do I do? Nah, we good. This is Impulse RC Driver Fixer, and it does exactly what you think. The download link is in the description below, and once that's done, you should see it appear, and bam, we can connect. We're just gonna have a quick look and see what version it is. So this is 4.2.11, and I want 4.3.1. So top right, I'm gonna hit Update Firmware, click Auto Detect, select 4.3.1, full chip arrays, go to the bottom, click load firmware align, and then flash. And it should download the firmware we need. This will take a minute, but once it's done, we should have a screen that looks like this. Connecting to the drone, we want to apply custom defaults, close this box, and calibrate the accelerometer. The ports tab is the next to configure. We're gonna set UART1 as RX, UART2 as GPS, and UART3 as MSP for the Vista. Config tab is next, and we're gonna give it 8K 4K, turn off the magnemometer, give the drone a name, set the arming angle to 180, and the RX lost beacon to turned on. Scrolling down, we're gonna turn on the GPS and set to auto detect. And on the right, turn off USB. We can save and reboot, and onto the next tab, power and battery. Gonna set my minimum to 3.4 volts and tell it how big my battery is. Easy. Next tab. We're gonna head over to the receiver now to set it up. Set to crossfire. Switch that telemetry on. And set our stick low to 1005 and stick high to 1995. Hit save and onto the next tab, which is failsafe. I'm going to gloss over the settings I'm doing here as these are dependent on what you are flying. Just know that if you have a GPS, select GPS Rescue. If not, select Drop. Now the next tab, Modes. This is completely personal to you. You're gonna have your own setup for this. Just make sure the AUX switches are aligned to the correct positions. OSD is next, and this is another thing that is personal to every pilot. As long as there is some sort of battery indication, signal indication, you should be good. Going to the black box tab, we're going to set up the logging device to onboard flash, 1K logging rate, and gyro scale. This is going to help us with tuning later on. Talking of tuning, time to go to the PID tuning tab, where we are going to leave everything default for this first flight. The only thing I'm going to change is the rates to how I like them, then hit save. The last thing to do is the motor tab. I'm going to run props out, DSHOT 600, and here I make the mistake of clicking bidirectional, but this is a BL Heli S ESC, not 32. Finally, in the new 4.3 Betaflight and above, motor mapping can be done with these two buttons here. Follow the wizard, and you should be good to go. Once that's done, unplug your USB and go fly. So listen, thanks for watching my Betaflight speedrun. This drone is going to be up flying soon, and I hope to show you some footage. Thanks for watching, and take it easy. Later.